If you're walking through cubicles and hear things like regulatory testing and coexistence followed by different four-letter words, just know that you've stumbled upon the local RF designer. But now you'll be able to help. Silicon Labs BGM 220 modules make it fast and easy to get your next design connected. And Sami Kaislaswo is here to tell us about how you can make life easier for those designers. Welcome to Tech Chat, Sami.
Thanks, Chris, and thanks for having me.
So let's just talk about IoT and wireless connectivity in general. It's a big market.
It is. It is a big market and a growing one, for sure. And we're in Silicon Labs are geared to be in that forefront of IoT.
A lot of these IoT devices have Bluetooth, and you really have this focus of making it easier to add Bluetooth. So what does that entail?
Yeah, we offer the complete solution all the way from hardware, being that SoCs or modules, to development tools and everything between. So on the hardware, we run our Bluetooth stack software. It brings the latest 5.2 features, all the latest mesh stack features. But it's not only about that. It's also the tools and the mobile application that we can offer for developers to build their own end products easily and fast.
What are some of those new features available in the latest Bluetooth spec?
Yeah, so the Bluetooth Low Energy, the first release of 4.0 was already multiple years ago, and it's increased in features and spec versions. And we at Silicon Labs have followed all of those features and bringing these to end customers. For example, I could bring out dynamic TX power control from the latest spec and features like that. And on the Bluetooth mesh side, we've been in the forefront from the initial release of the spec and been building that Bluetooth mesh solution all the time, bringing new features and so forth. But it's not only about that. It comes with also the platform components, if you will. So it's the bootloaders, the peripherals and drivers, the key storage and management, the radio level and so forth. So it's all that fundamental platform features and building the Bluetooth stack software on top of that, bringing easy use APIs to the developers to create their own application on top of that.
And you bring capabilities beyond just the Bluetooth stack. Can you talk about that?
Well, it's like, as you said, it's not only Bluetooth, it's also the fundamentals that you need in your end application. It's the over-the-air updates. Once you roll out your product, you need to be able to update it securely on the field. Or it can be features that build on top of Bluetooth, be it direction finding or wireless coexistence with Wi-Fi. So it's all that what you need to take care of in your end product.
Of course, that all pairs nicely with these modules that you offer. So what kind of benefits do designers get on the hardware side when they leverage these modules?
It's definitely key is the faster time to market through the global certification we have in our modules, and also less development risk that you have when you take a module. You have all the RF components already selected. They are optimized for that SoC, so you can trust that whatever you place, as long as it's following the guidelines, you can trust that the RF is compliant with the global certifications, but also that it will work as promised in the datasheet. Additionally to those, with the system and packaging, you get the benefit of a smaller size when we use these advanced packaging techniques where we can put a lot of components into a small space, and the benefit will be that you can create ever smaller end products with those. And still one more additional benefit is the reduced BOM count in that manufacturing phase. You can trust that from Silicon Labs, if you take the module, it's one component for the full RF solution, and you don't need to go to different vendors with different lead times and all that. So it simplifies also the manufacturing phase.
What about power consumption?
So our BG22 SoC platform was, or is our latest addition into the Bluetooth family, and it was fully optimized for battery-powered applications. And what we did here with the modules was that we needed and wanted to take the full benefit of that SoC capabilities. In the ultra-low power domain, it performs as well as the SoC, but also on the RF side, it can take the full benefit of the SoC as well, that we've optimized it for low power, but also for the best possible RF performance that we can get from that SoC.
Now you have these two module options. Let's talk about some of the similarities and differences between those.
So yeah, we have two packaging options. One is the system and package, the SIP, which comes in 6x6 millimeter size. It's up to 6 dBm on TX Power, offers 25 GPIOs, fully integrated antenna, or alternatively, you can choose an RF pin. And it comes with and without a shield, depending on the application and price range you're looking for. And then the other package alternative is the PCB module, the BGM220P. It's a 13x15 millimeter package, shielded up to 8 dB on TX, the same 25 GPIOs, built-in antenna, and here you have the option of selecting if you need really accurate sleep clock, you can have it either with an LFXO or without. And these even go to temperature ranges up to 105 Celsius. Both have similar set of certifications and Bluetooth qualification. The PCB module, it's fairly optimized already, and it definitely performs, giving optimized RF and really easy to integrate and manufacture, so you don't need any advanced manufacturing options. But when you want to do a really small design, the SIP is the solution for you. The 6x6 itself is really small, and it only requires a very small keep-out area, so keeping it the width similar size as the PCB module. So, for example, wearables or similar like type of products where you need to do small, slim designs, the SIP module is definitely the alternative. Like I've mentioned multiple times, we'll fully optimize the designs for performance and also ease of use. Design complexity is one thing, but then also comes the different aspects of the end product, be it the packaging or the enclosures that you choose. And here, what we've done with the optimization is that you can bring the enclosure next to the module without detuning the antenna, meaning that you don't sacrifice performance, even if you're doing those very slim and small packagings. And also, with this, you don't need to do spins of detuning the RF because it will perform as promised on the datasheet and so forth. So the performance is guaranteed with this product.
We've talked a lot about how the modules can save time and reduce risk on the hardware design. What do you do to make things easier for software developers?
Yeah, so definitely hardware is just the one aspect of the design, the software is equally important. And what we want to offer the developers is a very simple and simplified experience to get started and move forward, because it's critical to get to the market fast. So our solution here is the newly introduced Simplicity Studio 5 with the new interface, much more simplified and intuitive out-of-box experience, fast access to developer experience and it runs on multiple platforms. And it's the Simplicity Studio itself is set of tools. So it's the IDE, the code examples and so forth, but and compilers, but it also brings up utility tools like the network analyzer and the energy profiler that are great tools for a developer, making sure that the code is working as expected. It's performing low power as intended, and also the network or the RF is performing as expected.
Now, in that same vein of getting to market fast, you also mentioned some mobile tools and resources that you have, since mobile is a key to a lot of IoT devices.
Yeah, and especially when doing or creating these Bluetooth application, they often talk to a mobile phone, be it on the point-to-point or configuring a mesh node. So it is key to give a, first of all, platform to test out the functionality of a product quickly, but also then giving those source codes so developers can take these starting points and start developing on their own. So when you develop something on the embedded platform like our modules, you can get the instant feedback that, hey, this application works with my phone and I can control the embedded device from that app or see the device advertising and the mobile phone can scan it and get that data out of the embedded device. It's something that will definitely benefit those developers, and make sure to keep the app up to date because those updates are coming all the time.
Again, keeping with the fast and easy theme, tell me about your development kits.
So yeah, the important thing is that not only the software needs to be easy to use, but also the out-of-box experience with the developer tools need to be well thought and kind of work out of the box. So we do offer a set of options. So the wireless starter kit for the modules comes with two radio boards. So you can pick and choose the more appropriate device, both the PCB and the SIP module. We have just introduced the BGM220 Explorer kit, which brings another alternative for developers starting with the BGM220 modules. It's extremely low cost, easy accessible kit that offers access to various sensors and expansion options through these maker communities and other alternatives. So it has the BGM220P module on it, connectors for Qwik and MakerBus communities. It offers a USB connector to be debugged and connected to a PC, and IOs and buttons and LEDs to create those application and fast prototypes with this one before moving to actual product phases. You can find all sorts of sensor boards and displays and LEDs from the MakerBus community, as well as Qwik, where you can chain a set of sensors together from the smartphone community, making your prototyping as easy as it can be without yet creating your own designs. And you can also already get the software running on this Explorer kit and through these various sensor and display alternatives. You can find all these tools from mouser.com, the WSDK, and the Explorer kit by searching the BGM220 modules.
And one last question, Sami. There are a lot of Bluetooth modules available. So what would you say sets the BGM220 apart?
So we were able to create a very balanced and optimized solution that hits all the points on ultra-low power, great RF performance, and with the modules, the ease of use. You're able to take the module, look at the design guidelines, build your product around those guidelines, and you can trust that the end product will go, and you don't need to do recycles or respins of fine-tuning the RF, but the first or the second time, you're ready to go to mass production. And same with the software. So the simplicity is key, and getting started with the software, creating software on top of these examples that we provide and getting to the market fast is key. And the modules definitely help with that.
Thank you, Sami. Once again, that's Sami Kaislaswo from Silicon Labs. If you'd like to learn more about Silicon Labs BGM220 Bluetooth modules, click the links in the description or visit mouser.com. And be sure to check back soon for the next episode of Tech Chats.